So today we will discuss about the stimulating, conducting and the innervating system of the heart. First discussing about the conducting and the stimulating system of the heart. The impulse is generated in the SA node. This is the SA node. After the generation of the impulse passes myogenically to the atrium. Myogenical means through the walls of the atria. Through the wall of the atria, the impulse reaches the AV node. This is the AV node. After reaching the AV node, the impulse travels to the AV bundle. This is the AV bundle. AV bundle transmits the impulse from the AV node to the Purkinje fibers. Now this AV bundle divides into two parts. A right branch and a left branch. The right branch then proceeds in the interventricular septum deep to endocardium. This is the interventricular septum, and the endocardium is the innermost layer of the heart. The right branch then gives the Purkinje fibers, also called the subendocardial branches. These fibers supplies the wall of the right ventricle, muscle of the interventricular septum, and the anterior papillary muscle through the septomarginal tuberculi or moderate band. This is a moderate band. This is a muscular ridge situated at the interior side of the right ventricle. Now we will discuss the left branch of the AV bundle. The left branch of the AV bundle divides into six small tracts. This is not in the case of right branch. And also this septomarginal tuberculi is exclusive only for the right ventricle. This is absent in the left ventricle. So this is a point to remember. Now we were discussing about the left branch. The left branch divides into the six smaller tracts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Six smaller tracts. These smaller tracts then gives the Purkinje fibers. These Purkinje fibers stimulate the interventricular septum, anterior and posterior papillary muscles and the walls of left ventricle. Now we will discuss about the innervating system of the heart. The heart is supplied by the autonomical nerve fibers of the cardiac plexus. These autonomic fibers contain both the sympathetic and the parasympathetic fibers. First discussing about the sympathetic supply. The sympathetic fibers originate from the superior first five thoracic vertebrae as a presynaptic sympathetic fibers. The cell bodies of these presynaptic sympathetic fibers lies within the intermediolateral cell column. What is the intermediolateral cell column? The intermediolateral cell column is the cell column that forms the lateral horn of the spinal cord's gray matter. Now these presynaptic fiber, sympathetic fiber moves to the prevertebral ganglion, where the cell bodies of the postsynaptic sympathetic fiber lies. Now these postsynaptic sympathetic fibers innervate the SA node, AV node, myocardium of the heart and some blood vessels or coronary arteries of the heart. In the sympathetic supply, the nerves are mostly endogenic nerves. These endogenic nerves stimulate the SA node at the time of fight or flight when there is a need to increase the heartbeat. By stimulating the SA node, it causes the rapid depolarization, increasing AV conduction Second, it increases the atrioventricular contractility, the force by which the atria and ventricular contract is increased. Third, it releases the noradrenaline hormone that binds to the beta 2 receptors on the walls of the coronary blood vessels. This binding causes the relaxation of the vessels, cells of the vessel wall, that increases the blood supply to meet the need of the tissue. Now we will discuss about the parasympathetic supply. The parasympathetic supply is supplied by the vagal nerve. The vagal nerve originates from the medulla of the heart. It is a cranial nerve that originates near the medulla of the heart, carrying the presynaptic fibers. While in this case, the cell bodies of the postsynaptic fiber doesn't lie outside the heart, it lies inside the heart near the atrium or atrioventricular junctions. Now this vagal nerve stimulating the FC node and the AV node. The vagal nerve by the postsynaptic fibers, parasympathetic fibers, these fibers releases the acetylcholine hormone that binds with the muscarinic receptors. These muscarinic receptors are present in the SA node. This binding slows down the rate of depolarization of SA node, which is also called the pacemaker of the heart in most of the cases. In the abnormal cases, this pacemaker may be shifted in the AV node or in the Purkinje fibers. Now, the second function is to constrict the walls of coronary arteries, reducing the blood supply. That ultimately slows down the heart rate. So this sympathetic supply increases the heart rate, increases the blood supply, while the parasympathetic supply reduces the heart rate and the blood supply, so that the heartbeat returns to its normal rate. So this is all about the stimulating, conducting, and the innervating system of the heart.